Okay, where do I start? If you're with me at the blog TV thing showing the BET Awards last night, you had to have been, if you're a real Michael Jackson fan, you had to have been very disappointed. It really wasn't a tribute to Michael. The first part of the show, if you check out all the other performances and awards gathering that had nothing to do with Michael, I would say about a tenth of the 4-hour show was for Michael, which is not a tribute. A tribute show is that the entire show is about Michael. Okay? The entire show. Everything from rewards given to him, there was not one reward given to Michael. Probably 8 out of 10 people even said anything about Michael. Maybe 5 people did songs for Michael, like Jamie Foxx and Ne-Yo's song at the end of the show, dedicated to Michael. That whole show should have been dedicated to Michael, and it really wasn't. Let's just be real, it was not. Okay? People will disagree and say that I was wrong, but that a tenth of the show was about Michael. Okay? Barely anything about Michael. It was not dedicated to Michael. So don't call it a tribute show. But that wasn't what really got me angry. What got me angry, and if you, like I said, if you were at my blog TV show last night, you know what I'm talking about. What got me angry, and what has me even angrier today, was last night when CNN was there on the red carpet before the BET Awards started, and Don Lemon was interviewing Joe Jackson. Of all people, Joe Jackson decided to come on the behalf of Michael. We all wanted Janet. Heck, I even would have went with Jermaine if Jermaine didn't try to pull that stunt a few years ago on Michael trying to bring out a tell-all book against his own brother. But I would have handled that better if it was Jermaine or Janet there, or his mother for that matter. But of all people, it was Joe Jackson, and you all know we all can't stand Joe Jackson. We don't like him. Michael hated him, and we hate Joe Jackson ourselves. So what made me angry is the fact that the way Joe Jackson behaved last night, when Don Lennon was trying to ask him questions about the family, and all Joe Jackson wanted to talk about was his record company, which has nothing to do with Michael. Has nothing to do with Michael. He had some woman, one of his representatives there, read a statement that sounded so dry and so lifeless and so unfeeling, to represent the family and to represent Joe Jackson. This was written by Joe Jackson, so, and then she read whatever she had to read that Joe Jackson supposedly wrote, which again was dry and unfeeling and so crappy, if you want to be honest. Okay, I just it was uncalled for. Why was she reading it? Why couldn't Joe Jackson just say it from his heart if he had one? Now, I'll give Joe Jackson credit. He brought a beautiful son into this world, and it wasn't just him, it was Catherine too. So they both brought a beautiful son into this world, and he has changed the world. But all Joe Jackson can think about doing right now is promote his record company. Again, that has nothing to do with Michael. He acted so unfeeling. Don Lennon asked him, how was the family doing? How was the family coping with Michael's death? All he could say was, and this is how he said it. He was like, oh, well, they're doing all right, but look, I gotta make a statement. This is a very important statement, okay? This man right here, he and I started a record company together. What does that have to do with Michael? It has nothing to do with Michael. How dare you disrespect your family and your son? It has nothing to do with Michael. And then he comes out there today with Reverend Al Sharpton, which I respect Reverend Al Sharpton, but I do not respect what he did today. He actually condoned Joe Jackson after Joe Jackson went into this 3-minute talk of his record company. Oh, we got some great artists, and this is what Michael would have wanted me to do. Michael would not have wanted you to do that. If Michael would have wanted you to start a record company, Joe Jackson, you'd have started your record company years ago when Michael was living. But I'm under the impression that Michael didn't want you to do that. But now that Michael's dead and Michael can't say anything, you feel like, well, let me bask in my son's glory and steal some of this and use his reputation to promote my record company because I am the son of Michael Jackson and I could use that glory that Michael has to promote this record company. I'm gonna tell you right now, if your record company remotely gets big, if there was no justice in this world and your company got big, I would not buy nothing from you. Unless it has Michael's face on it and Michael's voice is singing on a CD, unless it's that, I'll buy something from you. But I doubt that it'll even get off the ground. Okay, just because you're Michael Jackson's father does not mean that you're going to get the glory that Michael got. I'm sorry, you must be dreaming in some kind of dream world. Maybe that 80-year-old Alzheimer's is kicking in or something. I don't know. But all I can tell you right now is that you will not get the glory that Michael got. So stop looking for it. You're disrespecting your son. You're pretty much blatantly spitting on the body of your son to promote your record company. And I don't agree with the fact that Reverend Al Sharpton even condoned that. To me, it seemed like Reverend Al Sharpton wasn't even believing what he was saying, trying to condone that. Michael is dead, and all of us are feeling it, especially those who really, really loved him. And we could definitely see that Janet was still feeling it last night. I was so glad that Janet came out there last night. It was so good to see her. She was the one person out of that entire family that I was more concerned about. And I was glad that she came out and cleared up and fixed up that train wreck that Joe Jackson did while talking to CNN. Okay, excuse me. My father walked in on me while I was in the midst of my rage. Where I left off at is that the mere fact is I want CNN and MSNBC to stop being cowards. Stop being cowards and call Joe Jackson out for what he really is. He's a fake. He's a fraud, and he's being very disrespectful to his own son. And his son has been dead 4 days now. Like I said, many of us are not over that. Many of us will probably never get over it. I'm probably one of those people who will never get over it. In fact, I know I'll never get over it, not to the fullest effect. But people were asking him, has the family made funeral arrangements and all that today? And he didn't even want to answer that. And he put on this fake, it was as fake as I don't know what. But this fake cracking in his voice that his son was so great. I'm so proud of my son. Joe Jackson is using his son reputation to build off his own. Now that Michael is dead, he feels that I can finally live out my dream through my son's legacy. That's all Joe Jackson is trying to do. I don't care how you try to justify what Joe Jackson has done. He hasn't done anything justifiable except bringing Michael into this world. That's the only thing he's done. Let's just be honest. Let's just call it out. This is not disrespecting Michael. What I'm saying is not disrespecting Michael. It's calling his father out for what he's disrespecting Michael today doing. This is calling Michael's father out. And this is why Michael hated his father so much. And I can understand that now. I can actually understand why Michael spent all his time and money changing his face so that he don't look like his father. I can understand that. Not condoning it, but I can understand that. I can definitely understand it now. Because if I look like Joe Jackson, I will try everything in my power to try not to look like him. He's not a father. He disrespected his son yesterday, disrespecting him again today, and disrespected his family. Why is he speaking for his family? He never spoke up for Michael before. He's saying that when Michael was living, nobody gave him this kind of appreciation. Is Joe Jackson on some drug himself? Is he on Demerol himself? Because it's like all Michael got all his life was appreciation and more, just like this. And he's saying that he wishing people realized that then and not now. It's not a case of realization. It's the case that this coming to cope with Michael's death. That is the hardest thing in the world that all of us who are fans are trying to do. And it'll never happen, really. And to me, Michael will never be able to rest in peace until his father passes away. Not even passes away. He won't die like everybody else. He'll just nasty away. Because he's being very nasty, okay? So he won't die like in dignity like other people. But I'm telling you right now, as soon as Michael is laid to rest, his body anyway, because Michael is already in heaven. Michael is resting. Michael is not even worrying about what's happening down here. But in the back of my mind, I clearly wish that Michael would haunt his father right now, at least until his father's dead, you know? But like I said, agree to disagree with what I'm saying, that's up to you. But as a Michael Jackson fan, it makes me angry. It makes me angry at what his father is doing. It's making me angry. Michael cannot rest in peace because of his father. That's the whole reason why Michael left the Jackson 5 and to get away from his father, to be free on his own, to be away from his brother so that he could be free on his own. That's why Janet Jackson, his sister, not as big as Michael, but that's why she has been successful. That's why she's been successful, because she got away from her family. Well, her father, really. And in my eyes, she's probably the closest to Michael, in my eyes. Every time Michael went through something, there was Janet. And she never took money, like LaToya and Jermaine. She never took money to be against her brother. She was there with him through thick and thin. That's why I was so glad to see her last night. So I want all these news and stuff to stop being cowards. Call Joe Jackson out for what he is. He's disrespecting Michael. Stop trying to cover it up and say, well, he's only doing this for Michael. He's not doing this for Michael. He's saying it in your face. He's not doing this for Michael. And Al Sharpton needs to check himself. He needs to check himself. Condoning what Joe Jackson just did today? Come on now. That's not an attempt for Michael. That's so that Joe Jackson can live out his life now that he's got his son is dead and now that he has his son's money. I hope that record company that he's trying to make fails completely. Don't nobody support him. Because I'm not supporting him. I'm not supporting Joe Jackson. I'm supporting Michael Jackson, but I will not support Joe. He has done nothing. Absolutely nothing. He was not giving his son praise anytime during Michael's life when Michael was going through all those troubles. He said nothing. I'm through. I just had to get that out. I am through. But it's up to you to determine on whether how you see this. But the way I see it, Joe Jackson is being a blatant disrespect to Michael. And I hope, boy, Michael's not gonna do this, but I really hope Michael haunts his father. My gosh. I mean, Joe deserves anything bad coming his way. We are all feeling Michael's loss. We are all feeling his death. We are all feeling that.